Hi there, and welcome to our week-ending edition of Hoo-Ha Sports Today. Of course, we'll bring you all the weekend's football fixtures and some good news for Malaysian fans from the badminton courts at the All England Championships. But we start with the old man who finally broke his silence, and no, it was not wind. Sir Alex Ferguson has finally lifted his self-imposed media blackout and spoke at a press conference ahead of Man United's big FA Cup clash with Arsenal this weekend. Ferguson believes that the Gunners are a serious threat to their league title challenge, saying, quote, "Clearly they represent the main danger to us, achieving our ambitions in a revival of the rivalry of a few years ago. And I'm sure they regard us as a major threat to their hopes," unquote. Eating humble pie, I see, knowing that he's in hot soup over an impending hearing with the FA on an improper conduct charge. That hearing is scheduled to take place sometime before the 25th, which may see Sir Alex at the stands for United's home match with Bolton next weekend, if he's found guilty by the FA. Ferguson already has a suspended two-match touchline ban hanging over him from a previous charge, and if the latest case is proven, he could receive a possible four-game ban that would include the Bolton game, plus a trip to West Ham, followed by matches at home to Fulham and away at Newcastle. A five-game ban could possibly mean that he faces the indignity of not being allowed in the dugout area for an FA Cup semi-final at Wembley, should United make it. And they could, as Arsenal will be without Cesc Fabregas, who is out for a minimum of 2 games, and goalkeeper Chesney is sidelined for a while with an injured finger. And Wenger has mentioned about bringing in a keeper on loan. Here are the FA Cup quarter-final fixtures for this weekend. United host Arsenal on Saturday, but before that kickoff, it's League Cup winners Birmingham who take on Bolton. On Sunday, Stoke entertain West Ham, while Manchester City, who haven't won a trophy since 1976, play Reading, who eliminated Everton a couple of days ago. And it will be hard for the blue half of Manchester, as they suffered a blow in the round of 16 of the Europa Cup competition last night. City lost 2-0 to Dynamo Kiev, with Andrei Shevchenko and Oleg Gusev bagging a goal each in either half. It was a fantastic night for Portuguese football as Braga defeated Liverpool 1-0, where manager Kenny Dalglish was utterly disappointed with his team's performance on the night. Then Benfica notched a 2-1 win over Paris Saint-Germain, while Porto had to do it away from home and came back with a vital 1-0 win at CSKA Moscow. Elsewhere, a thrilling match between Bayer Leverkusen and Villarreal. 5 goals in that one, with Nilmar netting the Spanish side's winner virtually with the last kick of the game. Ajax also lost at home, and Eindhoven and Rangers played to a scoreless draw. Now briefly to the Malaysian Super League fixtures in Match Day 7. Tonight, Johor FC take on the City Boys, and tomorrow sees league leaders Kelantan play away at Pahang. Chasing Kelantan are Perak, who travel to Terengganu to face club side T-Team, while the East Coast State Team visit Kedah. Other fixtures include Fedah United and Perlis. Sabah take on the Young Tigers, and the match of the week is between Negeri Sembilan and Selangor. To news on badminton, and you can temporarily breathe a sigh of relief as our remaining men's doubles pairs and Lee Chong Wei all made it through to the quarterfinals of the All England Championships. Chong Wei defeated Bao Chun Lai in straight sets and will meet Thailand's Boonsap Pornsana. Doubles pair of Koo Kian Kiat and Tan Boon Hyang disposed of their Taiwanese opponents and will face Indonesia's Marcus Kido and Hendra Setiawan. While Mohammad Zakri and Hu Tianhao, who beat Japan's Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hayakawa in 3 sets of 12-21, 21-14 and 21-19, have another tough encounter when they play the top doubles seed of Mathias Bo and Carsten Mogensen of Denmark. And finally, in Formula One's Day 3 testing at Barcelona, where the Red Bull boys once again showed improved reliability when Mark Webber clocked the third fastest time in a trouble-free 97 laps. But it was rookie Sergio Perez of the Sauber team that surprised everyone with the fastest time in the 3 sessions so far, with a time of 1 minute 21.761 seconds. Ferrari's Felipe Massa was 3 tenths ahead of Webber in second. And that's a wrap for this week. Join me again on Monday, where we'll bring you a recap of the weekend's action. Until then, from the team and I, here's wishing you a great sporting weekend, and it's bye for now.